SoundHound up 100% since last month's earnings report, but now the volatility is already underway. Here to break it all down for us is MarketBeat analyst Thomas Hughes. Thomas, this has been a great month for SoundHound.
Yeah, it really has been. And what we have here is kind of a perfect storm of factors driving the stock price. It starts with their results. The company's growing and it's accelerating. It's gaining traction. The forecasts for next year are for this hyper growth to accelerate and continue again. So another 100% growth in the revenue next year. The forecast may be cautious because of the Investor Day conference. The Investor Day conference left the market feeling very confident about the future. Also revealed some new deals in a deal pipeline that kind of reinforces all this outlook for how good the next year is going to be. And on top of that, there's the short interest. The short interest was nearly 30% at the beginning of the month. And so a lot of this upward movement in the stock price is short covering.
Let's talk about that movement in the stock price. What have we seen this stock do since earnings last month?
Well, like you said, it's up more than 100%. But technically speaking, what we're looking at is a break above a significant resistance point. So it suggests the upward momentum can continue. The last week's big surge was also on pretty high volume. Again, part of that was short covering, but the high volume kind of shows a lot of market support for the stock at the price level that it's at now. So we're looking at higher prices to come over the next year.
Now, we've talked about SoundHound on this channel before. What came out during earnings report and that investor call this month that has investors even more excited about the future of SoundHound?
Well, it just shows that the company is gaining traction. Its technology really is good. It works. The Investor Day conference, you know, the market walked away thinking, wow, this stuff really does work. It sounds good. It's kind of seamless, providing a good service for businesses. This new deal that they announced is with Torchy's Tacos. That's for 130 stores. It's not a lot of stores. They've got about 10,000 restaurants using the software. But they're talking about, for Torchy's, the software is handling 100% of their calls. It's taking orders. It can take more than one order at a time. It's answering questions. So it's really helping the business become more efficient. And that just plays into the outlook for not only for revenue growth, but for earnings potential.
Yeah, it's really one of the great usage of AI is to really take away something that's time consuming, that takes a lot of human power and make it faster. And I think that's why the idea behind SoundHound is taking off so quickly.
Well, right. Broadly speaking, the services and automation is what the current, you know, evolution of AI is best for handling data, routing the data where it needs to go, and then responding to queries and requests.
Well, let's talk about what are analysts saying about SoundHound's future?
Well, so the analysts are pretty bullish, but I would say the stock price has kind of front run their sentiment. They're living their price targets. But I think right now the stock price is about 40% overvalued relative to consensus. So that plus the short covering element leads me to think that there could be some volatility. We might expect a pretty sharp price pullback before we see new highs set. But ultimately, the trend is positive, and I would expect the analysts to catch up with the market given time.
Yeah, sometimes it can be hard to play these short interest stocks. But if you want to learn more about how to play high short interest stocks, check out this free MarketBeat report. It'll break down everything you need to know about playing stocks just like this one that have a lot of high short interest right now. So Thomas, what would be a really good trading play on a stock like SoundHound that's seen such a big run-up so quickly?
Well, right. So looking at this from the bull case and, you know, assuming that this bull fundamental situation scenario really is playing out the way that I've described, you would want to wait for some price pullbacks. And the price pullbacks will probably result in pretty clear demarcations of support levels, and then use those for entry points. If you have an opposite viewpoint, you're probably going to want to look for some of these recognizable resistance points and use those as possible places to short the stock.
With rapid growth stocks like this one, you always wonder about what kind of factors could potentially slow down all of these really quick gains. Is it competition? Are there competitors out there that might come take away some of SoundHound's market share? Are there other economic factors or just things that could impact this growth trajectory for this company?
Well, right now, SoundHound is the leader in its field, but I would say that most other AI companies are working towards similar ends. Salesforce in particular is a company that's going to want to use AI to automate its workflows for businesses. And it is a potential, you know, buyer for SoundHound. But again, we got to remember that SoundHound is being backed by NVIDIA. So it's a good chance that SoundHound will remain a standalone company for a very long time.
That was a question for the bears that might be out there, but for the bulls, what could lead to even more growth for SoundHound? I'm sure there's plenty of companies that are really just starting to explore how AI applications like this one could help their business.
Well, I think that the growth trajectory for this company is pretty robust. Businesses in general need to be efficient. They need automation. So the more businesses within one industry take on software like this, the more the competition will need to follow suit. So I think that this story is one that could continue to gain traction over the next couple of years. And right now, SoundHound's revenue is less than $100 million a year. This company is going to be worth billions pretty soon. So I would expect to see it grow by 100% or more over the next few years, like each year annually. AI services are going to be the largest and fastest growing segment of the AI market. So right now, if you think that the NVIDIA bubble is a big bubble, wait until the services bubble gets inflated and we'll see how big the market gets then.
Yeah, the rapid growth we're seeing in the whole AI sector is really incredible. And SoundHound is absolutely a part of that story. Thank you so much, Thomas, for the breakdown on what's happening with SoundHound right now. And thank you for joining us. Check out some of our other videos we've done on SoundHound in the past if you want to learn a little bit more about this company. As always, thank you so much for joining us and happy investing.